Welcome again to another edition of Fashion Counsel. My name is Anthony Lupo, and I have the pleasure of being joined today by Mike Stevens. Mike has worked with many clients in the fashion and luxury goods industry, and I want to start today with a discussion about personal appearance. Many of our fashion clients are really looking for people to work in their stores that actually represent the brand. But clearly that this is very close to the edge and they can get in a lot of trouble. What would you advise these clients on the best way to be able to do this, if they can even?
Yeah. It's a complicated problem, Tony. First of all, you should know that at the federal level, there's no law that prohibits discrimination based on personal appearance. There are, however, laws in some states and in cities like the District of Columbia that prohibit discrimination based on personal appearance. There are also laws in some cities and states that prohibit discrimination based on weight. So in those jurisdictions, if a fashion company were to make a decision on a store employee based on those protected characteristics, they could be subject to some potential liability. But generally speaking, fashion companies want their store employees to be ambassadors of the brand.
Exactly.
And they often ask them to dress in their clothes and to act in a certain manner that is consistent with the brand. And in general, I don't think there's anything wrong with companies looking for employees who can wear their clothes and look good in their clothes and be good ambassadors of the brand, as long as they don't do that in a discriminatory manner. There is
discriminatory means what? Race primarily? Is that what we're talking about?
In many cases, it's race, but the discrimination laws prohibit discrimination based on national origin and sex and disability in many cases. But there is a defense in most discrimination laws called BFOQ, bona fide occupational qualification. And if you can show as a fashion company that it's a bona fide occupational qualification for a store employee to be able to dress in your clothes and to be able to project the image of your brand, you may be able to defend it against a claim of discrimination.
So let's talk about uniforms for a moment. And I use uniforms loosely because many of these fashion clients clearly would never consider their clothing a uniform, but that's what we fall under. So if I'm in a luxury good company and I want my staff to wear higher end clothing, you know, either from my brand or another brand, can I do this? Can I impose this?
You certainly can require employees to wear a uniform or to dress in a certain way, but in certain states there are issues that arise. For example, if you require them to wear your brand or some type of uniform in California, for example, you would be required to pay the cost of that clothing and to maintain the clothing. There are some issues where if the clothing is suitable for streetwear in the employee's ordinary wardrobe, where you can argue that it's not a uniform. Another issue that often comes up is taxation. If you're going to be providing the employees with your clothing and shoes and whatever, that could be taxable income to the employee. So lots of issues when you deal with uniforms and dress codes.
So let's just bring this to an example. I have a client that, let's assume, is a denim company, and they want their people to wear their denim in the store and not a competing brand. You're telling me that's probably safest to offer that for free or some discount?
Well, it really depends on the culture of the company, and it depends on the location where the work is. But if it's in California and the denim is of a particular style or design, then it's probably going to be considered a uniform, and you have an obligation to provide it.
Interesting. Thanks again for joining me.
Thanks, Tony.